In the original Dalek hierarchy from before the Time War, Red Daleks played a significant role in the compartmentalization and management of Dalek operations across the universe. Considered to be higher in rank than grey, blue, or silver Daleks, but subordinate to black Daleks and gold Daleks, Red Daleks were essentially regional managers of the Dalek race, often taking a leadership role as a section leader or as a superior authority to several subordinate section leaders. As with most Dalek command ranks, the exact responsibilities undertaken by Red Daleks varied from situation to situation. Some were saucer commanders, others were placed in charge of particularly significant Dalek research stations or planet-side operations, some acted as first lieutenants to black Daleks, and others took a frontline role as generals. Initially, there was only one Red Dalek, often referred to as the Red Dalek Leader, who was third in command of the Dalek Empire after the Dalek Emperor and the Black Dalek Leader. This Red Dalek rarely left the Emperor's side, and formed the basic template for the rank of Red Dalek by acting as the closest thing the early Daleks had to a section leader. Another Red Dalek did exist in this early era of Dalek history, Dalek Zeg, a scientist who accidentally invented metal earth and challenged the Emperor for leadership of the Dalek race. But Zeg's red coloration was a result of his laboratory accident, which transformed his standard casing into red metal earth, and not a reflection of his rank. When the first Red Daleks were mass-produced to act as a commander class for the Daleks that were subordinate to black Daleks, they took on section leader roles, commanding lower-ranking Dalek drones in various Dalek operations. However, as the Dalek Empire grew and their ranks were expanded, the position of section leader was often given to grey or silver Daleks, and red Daleks were considered to be one rank above them. Red Daleks of this era were given considerable autonomy, and many examples of red Daleks played a role that would later become associated with black Daleks, as the even more superior rank of gold Dalek hadn't been implemented yet. In some circumstances, in the absence of a higher ranking Dalek, red Daleks were capable of assuming positions such as controller, taking command of an entire Dalek occupation force. Instances of this were rare, however, not least because there is also much confusion over the exact rank of certain prominent Dalek leaders. Some sources indicated that the Black Dalek in command of Dalek operations on Kemble in the year 4000, often considered to be not only a Black Dalek but the original Black Dalek leader himself, was in fact a Red Dalek. But this is unconfirmed and is just another example of Dalek history being not only chaotic, but also inconsistently documented. However, by the time of the Second Dalek War, Red Daleks as a standard rank became more rare. The introduction of the Gold Dalek rank, which replaced the role that Black Daleks had played and essentially demoted Black Daleks to a lesser rank, meant that the role of Red Dalek was largely superfluous. Dalek drones could act as section leaders, and Black Daleks now played the role of lieutenants, meaning Red Daleks were less common. Some prominent Red Daleks did exist in splinter factions, however. A Red Dalek led the force of Thaleks in the Antares galaxy as a result of a twisted Thal experiment that went wrong, and Alpha, leader of the humanized Daleks, donned a red casing when he established himself as leader of the Daleks in hiding from the main Dalek Empire. During the Time War, the rank of Red Dalek was reintroduced, but as part of a whole new ranking system. The rank of Gold Dalek was disposed of, and Black Daleks remained as commanders, but Red and Gold Daleks were introduced to hold the rank of Dalek Supreme. Several of these units saw action during and after the Time War, most notably the Red Supreme Daleks that worked with Davros aboard the Crucible in the Medusa Cascade and on the rebuilt Dalek City on Skaro, respectively. Following the rise of the new Dalek paradigm, the ranks of the Dalek military were once again reshuffled, with blue Daleks being reintroduced as strategists and red Daleks taking the role of officer-class drones, tasked with leading small squadrons of bronze Daleks into battle. What do you think of the role of Red Dalek? Are there any prominent Red Daleks out there that weren't mentioned in this video? Do you want to see Red Daleks appear as part of a new Dalek redesign for the next series? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below.
Don't forget to click below to subscribe to
Dalek Bumps.